Let's go, it's the Whitey Show. Whitey Show.
With Sparkle Man, and I ain't got time to shake your hand. Get that side check. Put it in pockets like a sack.
Lego the Movie game is out, and the movie was a smash hit. Everyone I know seemed to love it, and I like Lego games too. And Marvel Lego was fantastic and my number one choice for a launch pickup title. So this should follow in its footsteps, right? Let's find out if this movie game is beyond just a simple movie type game. The good are the fun graphics and atmosphere. I haven't seen the movie yet, I plan on doing so, but it looks colorful and fun and the game does a good job of grabbing that too. The worlds all look different and it's great and the overall animations are also nice. The wonderful story in this game is wonderful. Awesome! Is it awesome? Right? Okay. Anyway, the song is basically describing the story. It follows the movie, but the little things that they say to each other as well in the levels is cracking me up. Both fun and enjoyable. The story is full of wit and humor, something both kids and adults could overall enjoy. Up, camera seems to work better than the Marvel game, not as crazy or mixy matchy, and the co-op in general is still really easy and you can jump into it right away and it's always fun to grab a partner for some two-player funness. Now, the bad start with the very easy puzzles. None of them had me stomped like the Harry Potter game or the Marvel game. Most were extremely easy or overdrawn to the point where it was more of a drag to do them instead of actually being fun. The combat is also a big step down from Marvel. Gone are the combos and back are the simple punch and kicks. What the beep? I'm not gonna curse because it's for children, but it's a big waste here. The levels also feel either hit or miss. Some levels are a lot of fun, while others are so annoying and boring that you have to wonder who tested this game and gave it the green light. And the only ugly is sometimes I'm trying to press a switch or do an action and it simply doesn't work. It doesn't feel responsive like the other Lego games, and that just isn't good. I didn't hate Lego the Movie game, in fact, I had a lot of fun with it. But it's also a fact that it's a serious downgrade from Marvel and Harry Potter ones. It's rushed, and for that, it feels more negative than it should. It still has the charming story and the fun co-op adventure with the bright fun worlds to explore. However, after coming from Marvel, I can't help but feel disappointed. I'm gonna give this one a 6 out of 10, and while not horrible, it still only fails short from the other LEGO games, and it's only in the okay category. Maybe renting or buying one very cheap.